this episode of Ghost Hunters International, the team gets help from three new investigators on the case of a lifetime. Scott.
I'm about to break out some New York on this.
Carl.
Sounds like rocks being tossed.
And Susan.
I think I just saw a shadow.
In Robin Hood's neck of the woods, can the team find evidence of the evil Sheriff of Nottingham?
Is that you?
Sounds like it's coming from over your side.
Rob feels the heat in a prison cell.
I'm like getting chills up and down my back.
While Paul and Ashley track down the ghost of a merry man.
What was that?
That was loud.
There's nobody else investigating anywhere near where we are right now.
Then, Paul confronts an entity in the galleries of justice.
What the hell is that?
You guys, this is our new investigator Scott. Scotch from his old team in Florida.
In my opinion, people get into the paranormal for many reasons. One could be that they lose someone close to them and they want to make sure that they're okay. Two is that they just want to get into the scientific aspect of it. Three is they want to thrill seek. I believe I fall into all three.
And from Ghost Hunters Academy, we've got Susan and Carl joining us.
Hey guys.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
I really have a passion for the paranormal. On top of that, I love to travel, and I'm really excited that I managed to capture this opportunity.
We have a big case coming up. I have some new equipment that I need to run by you.
Excellent. So I just came from Ghost Hunters Academy, and now I'm joining up with the international crew here. And it's a really important step, I think, in the development toward becoming an investigator.
Barry, everything ready to go?
We're good.
Let's get to it. Hop in the cars. Let's move. Cool. It's really exciting to have Susan and Carl come out and join the team. They've worked with Steve and Tango, who are two seasoned investigators, and have the stamp of approval from both Jay and Grant. All right, so we're here in Nottingham, England. Got a big team for a big case, and Brandy's going to give us the details of the history.
Okay, we are headed to the Galleries of Justice. Now, this place is believed to be the actual birthplace of the Robin Hood story.
I like Robin Hood.
Robin Hood is cool.
Robin steals from the rich to give to the poor. The evil Sheriff of Nottingham tries to capture him. Well, the Galleries of Justice was, at one time, the headquarters for the Sheriff of Nottingham, who actually used false imprisonment and robbery to gain monetary funds. Now, the Galleries of Justice now operates as a museum. It has 7 floors, it has 2 courtrooms, caves, a lot of other areas, all containing paranormal activity.
It's a good thing we got you guys.
Our client's name is Martin. He'd really like for us to be able to come in and really give him some definitive answers.
All right, this is it. Pulling up right now.
Wow.
Nice to meet you.
A big welcome from the Galleries of Justice, and thank you very much for coming here today. I think the Galleries of Justice is so unique. It's got everything that you want from a haunted location. And if GHI are able to capture physical evidence, that's the most exciting part for me, and it'd be great to see that. The caves underneath, they've been used as prisons, so if Robin Hood truly did exist, he would have been kept here in the caves below. There was 123 executions here, and if you was one of those public executions, you would have walked through this very hall, through there, and actually been executed on a scaffold in front of 60,000 people.
You'd be hung, not to the point of death, but just to the point where you've lost an element of consciousness, and then you'd be tied to either carts or to horses and pulled apart.
This very room here is actually haunted by a white lady seen on the stairs behind you. And next to Barry, actually a gentleman is usually seen there in Victorian gear, dressed all in black, long top hat. I think the best place to start is if we move into the courtroom.
Barry and Paul, why don't you go with me on the tour? Everyone else, just hang tight and we'll see you in a bit.
Myself and the caretaker went to the courtroom, and as we got to the door, we heard a conversation taking place, and as we opened the door and went in, the conversation stopped, and there was absolutely nobody in the room.
This is the main courtroom, and what you see here is up on these balconies, people have actually reported seeing figures walking from the left to right, And also, just over there in that corner, people have seen a figure leaning over, a misty white-shaped figure. One of the most consistent stories that we receive is the appearance of somebody called Justice Black. He did actually exist. People have said that they've actually seen the figure sitting in that chair there. People who've sat in there have also experienced transfiguration. Mm-hmm. And even young, pretty young women have actually changed into an older gentleman.
Transfiguration, the belief that spirit can manipulate our appearance, is a very rare event indeed.
He's never seen anywhere else but just that chair. You're now entering the modern cell block. It's in this area where I had my own experience. We were actually down at the bottom of the stairs when all of a sudden we heard that gate slam. And we heard footsteps, and then we saw that door just closing as well. We searched the whole building, there was nobody in the building. And the sounds of bars being rattled, knocked, closed, seems to be something that's happening all the time in this area. Objects are being known to come out of this cell, as if somebody's thrown pens, stones. People have heard footsteps, that sort of thing. So this is one of the most paranormally active areas. Shall we move on?
Sure. Yeah.
Down here is the dark cells. This would have been like solitary confinement. So people were kept down here in the absolute pitch black. They would have been brought into these two cells here. One of the most fearsome stories that has ever happened while we've been here is a young woman was with her 8 friends in here. She could see some movement in that cell that you see there. When all of a sudden, a black shadowy figure leapt from out there, pushed her, and hit her against the wall. She then checked where her collarbone was, and there was 2 imprints, 2 bruised imprints. We asked her friends, what did you see? And they all witnessed this.
And that's one of the better stories of activities that we've heard, for that many people to witness an attack. I mean, this is definitely something we're gonna wanna check out.
Do you wanna see the caves?
Okay.
This cave, nobody knows quite sure why it was built and whether it was just used as some form of dungeon. The interesting thing is people knew of Robin Hood's tunnel, so the likely chance is if he did exist, if he was a Nottinghamshire outlaw, he would have been here.
I was actually going through the caves, and just as I was actually walking, I just had this feeling that there was something behind me, and it was one of those moments where all of the hairs on your arms would just stand on end. I didn't want to turn around because I felt that if I did turn around, I would see something that I really didn't want to see.
But the ghost that's seen down here is actually seen carrying a candle. People have had stones gently thrown at them.
The candlelight, when it's emanating, does it show anything else, or is it just kind of this light moving through?
They see a flickering orangey light lighting up the back wall, but no shadows. It just seems to be moving behind these pillows here. Directly below you is an oubliette.
Now, an oubliette is a French word meaning a place to forget. A bell-shaped construction of about 60 feet underground, where prisoners will be flung into and left to die. So the idea being that they're being left to forgotten.
We have had sounds of people's groaning, voices.
Yeah, all right. We're going to go grab the rest of the team, start getting set up, and we'll see you in a couple of days to let you know how we did.
Excellent.
All right.
Thank you.
Galleries of Justice is an incredible opportunity for both the GHI team and the people coming to us from Ghost Hunters Academy. This place has every kind of activity you could want. Full bite apparitions, disembodied voices, EVPs, object manipulation, physical attacks. So it's going to be a test for all of us, and one that I'm looking forward to.
Barry, how's that look, Matt?
That's grand.
Run through the cameras.
Okay, camera number 1 is in the lobby here, where the Victorian lady is said to descend the stairs, and of course the gentleman that stands in front of Robin Hood here. Camera number 2 is in the main courthouse, where the apparitions of shadows are said to pass on the other balcony. Camera number 3 is down in the washroom, where the apparition is said to appear. And camera number 4 is down in the first level of the cell block, where these doors are said to close.
All right, so let's get the lights out quick and get right to investigating.
Great.
The modern girls, voices, sounds, not big of equipment. The thermal camera was there. We had a variety of EMF detectors, as well as audio recorders, everything we could think of that might help us document any changes.
We know a lot of awful things happened here in the past. We're just trying to figure out who you are.
Hey, if there's anyone in the hallway, you want to see what we're doing in here, please be our guest. Starting to get some, a little more rapid flux here. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, look at that. Are you coming in this way? Come on in. 2, 3, 2, 3. We see the numbers changing.
Yep, 5.
Going up.
Yep.
gear set up, we began to see a flux in the EMF field, indicating that potentially something was moving by. Is this your cell? Okay. If you're now in the room, give me some indication that you've arrived. I'm feeling really chilly in here now.
This is going up 3-2, 3-2, 3-2.
And nothing else. This doorway and nothing else. You're giving us the indications that you've joined us in the room. We need more than that. Put a thermal on me. I'm like getting chills up and down my back. Hey, if there's anyone in the hallway, you want to see what we're doing in here? Come on in the room. Put a thermal on me. I'm like getting chills up and down my back. Scott and I were investigating the modern cells when I suddenly felt a cold sensation come over my body. I don't know if it's just... It's check that door. How much...
No.
It's raining here. All right. Hey. If you did come... I'm like getting chills. If you did come to join us, thank you. It is cold, man. Like, I guarantee.
And I didn't feel
the freaking hair on my arm is up.
Yeah, and I don't...
Look at that, bro. The temperature plummeted right in one area. We checked to look for where the air drafts might be coming in or out. We couldn't find anything to explain it.
I don't know if we got used to it, but it seems to have gotten warmer.
It seems to have gotten warmer. Thank you.
Yeah.
I mean, the thing to me is this, and this is personal theory that some share. When you go to the gym, right?
Do I look like I go to the gym?
Okay, when I go to the gym. Okay. When I go to the gym, you work out, you work out, you work out, you put up your big weight, mm-hmm. and then the energy just drains away.
It might be very hard for it to manifest any kind of
manipulation. Just using any more energy at this point may be gone. So at this point, after a really good investigation like that, it's going to be really exciting to go back, go look for those EVPs, and see how much communication was really taking place. EVP session, and...
I think what we'll do here, Brandy, is maybe hold an EVP session. Mm-hmm. I'll go upstairs onto the balcony.
Okay.
Over there. Mm-hmm. And I'll shoot down onto this area.
Barry and I headed into the reception area of the Galleries of Justice, where the claims are of a couple different apparitions, one of a woman seen on the staircase, as well as a man that's been seen by the statue of Robin Hood. So Barry went up to the balcony area. He started taking full spectrum shots with his camera. I stayed down below in the lobby area running an EVP session. I'd like to speak to the woman wearing Victorian clothing that's been seen here. Can you come forward? I'd like to know why you're still here. Are you angry? Is that you?
Nope.
Both Barry and I heard a noise that sounded like a breath or a sigh, and I looked around, but I couldn't find anything. To the man that's been seen here in this lobby, no one seems to know who you are. Can you tell us what your name is? When people have seen you, you look like you're dressed fairly well. Were you a guard? A judge? One last time, I'm calling out to any spirit or entity that would like to communicate. Please come forward now.
Okay, I think we'll wrap it up here, Brandy.
Okay, but hopefully, you know, we captured something on either audio or one of the still photographs that Barry was taking.
Decided to check out the courtroom to investigate some of the claims that included people sitting in the pews and actually having their seat hit or feel like it was being hit, report of a black shadow floating around.
This is EVP session. Hall and Scott, we're in the courtroom.
I'm not here to judge you, nor am I here to harm you. Neither myself or Scott are here to hurt you in any way. I simply want to communicate with you.
What was your conviction?
Your sentence has been passed. Your crimes have been paid for. You are free to leave. Can you give us a sign? Do you understand what I am telling you?
What was that?
Are you kidding me? If that was your acknowledgement that you understood, I would request that you do that again.
What was that?
It sounded like people moving.
No one down here.
Huh?
I think I'm gonna sit in the back, Paul. Seems to be a few more sounds back here.
Absolutely, absolutely. There is certainly no reason to be scared. Whoever you are, or whatever you are, I demand you to come forward.
Do you hear that?
I thought it came from where you were.
It's close, but I can't tell if it was behind me or above me.
Make yourself known to us.
I thought I actually saw something, just a shadow, like right around here. I think you're being too nice, too proper and British. I'm about to break out some New York on this. Tired of these games. Paul's tired of these games. We come in here, we hear a noise in the back, we hear a noise in the front, and then nothing. What are you trying to accomplish? Did you hear that? It's the same place.
Is that true?
The hell is that?
The hell is that? Make yourself known to us. Scott and I were doing an EVP session in the courtroom.
Did you hear that? The hell is that?
The hell is that? Screw this.
The hell? Something's playing with us.
We're both hearing several sounds, and all of a sudden we heard a loud bang coming from the back of the room, so I decided to chase after it.
I think we need to go upstairs.
You think somebody is actually out there?
It could be hiding up there or something.
If you want to go upstairs, go upstairs.
I don't know, man. No one down here.
Okay, if you don't see anything up there, then why don't you head back down? If there was an entity in the room, our aggressive tactics may have scared it off.
And Susan in the main courthouse. This was once the seat of good old Judge Black.
Seems that good old Judge Black performs
transconfiguration.
Okay.
Transconfiguration happens whenever this spirit enters your body, interferes with your visual appearance. Your face changes. And you take on some of the attributes of that said spirit. Now, of course, this only happens to people who sit
on the chair.
In that chair. Would you be willing to take the challenge of sitting in that chair?
Absolutely.
Transconfiguration is a very rare event, and Susan and I come in here to explore that particular claim. Judge Black, we've been told tales of transconfiguration from those who sit in the chair.
Only like a slight breeze on my right cheek. Can you affect my mood and change my face? I feel a little sensation going through my arms, all the way down to my fingertips.
Okay.
But I'm not scared or anything.
Uh-huh.
You know, I've come a long way to meet the famous Judge Black. I will allow you to make full contact with me if you want. My head's feeling a little heavy.
Okay.
Feeling a little bit zoned out.
I glimpsed down at one of the shots to see some unusual form which had appeared in one of the photographs. I can't say for sure what it exactly is. I need to get back to analysis to see that.
What was that?
Oh, break it, hell. Those stupid dummies scared the crap out of me. Everything seems okay back here, Susan. Didn't seem to be anything moving around.
I feel really jittery.
We're going to bring you down out of there, Susan.
Okay.
Robin Hood's Tunnel. Carl and I headed to Robin Hood's Tunnel, and the reports of activity are various in this area. Everything from dark masses approaching people and surrounding them to a flicker of candlelight moving about the room. I'd like to introduce ourselves and let you know what we're doing here. My name's Rob, and this is Carl. Now, we understand that one of the ways you've been able to communicate in the past has been throwing stones and pebbles. Could you do that now? Robin Hood, are you here with us?
If you know of some way as yourself, or to be able to be seen, can you try it out for us?
People have said that you come right up to them. If you want to come up to me, you want to go up to Carl, you have our full permission. Keep hearing little, like, ticks back there?
Yeah.
Are you here with us? It's from right back there.
Sounds like rocks being tossed.
Sounds like it's coming from here. Carl and I headed to Robin Hood's Tunnel and heard two, like, faint taps. Keep hearing little, like, ticks back there?
Yeah.
It's from right back there.
Sounds like rocks being tossed.
Sounds like it's coming from back here.
All right, while we were sitting down here, there was the sound that almost sounded like a rock being thrown.
We're not here to, you know, get rid of your sin.
Was that you?
That wasn't me.
I sit in this doorway and have listened. Came again?
Yeah, I know. You know what it is?
Is that water? Drop it on that wooden surface there. That would explain a lot of things. We realized quickly it was condensation dripping down onto the wood. Further back up in the tunnel, which sounded like the rock sound. So it could definitely explain what's happening. People might not expect water to be down here, so they might not come to that conclusion.
We're good to go.
So I came down to investigate the dark cell.
There was a group in here, and there was a woman standing right here.
Mm-hmm.
And she was adamant she could see something moving in that cell, and as she's talking about how something's here, it jumps out at her, okay, throws her against the wall with two hands, holds her throat up, and when she was finally released, she had two bruises, like thumb bruises on her collarbone, kind of creepy. Yeah. The other thing is, in that cell, there's a bench, and apparently as people have sat on it, they've had the feeling, they have the sensation that someone's sitting next to them. Okay, well, this is an EVP session. Paul and Ashley were in the dark cell right now. So come on.
Touch one of us.
You're in there.
Push one of us. Either one of us. We're not afraid. That's why we're standing right here.
Throw me up against the wall. If you can do it to one person, you can do it to two. Come on. I dare you. What's wrong? You just like to pick on women? Is that what this is? What are you scared of, eh? Come on, show me me how badass you are. Come on. You're nothing. You're scared. That's what it is.
You must be.
Yeah.
I'm glad we heard it at the same time.
There's nobody else investigating anywhere near where we are right now.
Now that was loud.
And that was pretty close. I mean, that would probably most likely have been in the room. You know what? We should sit down on that bench.
Okay.
Okay, mind your head. If you sit on one end and I'll sit on the other.
Okay. I can only imagine what I must have felt to have spent all those days down here.
See, I don't care. You probably deserved it. You're a disgrace.
Could you come forward and show yourself to us? I didn't know, but something just knocked on the wall. Or I felt it.
Magic.
Yeah, I felt it.
If that was you, can you do it again?
My hands are here. I had my back up against the wall and we were asking just a bunch of basic EVP questions, and in the middle of that, I felt something kind of like as if the wall vibrated a little bit, as if someone tapped it.
Stay where you are. I'm going to go around there and tap the wall.
Okay. Paul actually went into the other room and tapped the other side of the wall to try to recreate that. That was it. It was like that. But I felt more. Like, you know, it sounded just like that.
It sounded like that, but it was more of a punch.
But it was one.
Uh-huh.
It was one knock. It sounded just like that, but it was as if I, like, felt it kind of in my back, with my back against the wall.
Uh-huh.
And it sounded the same, but I didn't actually feel it.
Can be used in two modes, active or passive. In passive mode, it measures ambient light changes throughout the room. In an active mode, we put out either UV light or infrared light and measure the changes that could take place.
So what we're going to do is use this in an active fashion, so...
Okay.
So we've got a shooting towards the door. What it means is it's getting a change in the amount of light coming from the door. Come towards the machine. There's nothing to be afraid of. It can't hurt you. Or maybe it can.
Holy crap.
We've got active passive lights shooting towards the door.
Robin and I decided to come investigate the night cell, and the light meter started to go off.
There's nothing to be afraid of. It can't hurt you. Or maybe it can.
Holy crap.
Is this thing hurting you? You want us to turn it off?
Whenever he asked if the UV hurt, the lights would start to speed up.
Doing now is we're not emanating, we're not sending the UV out. So this is just regular light. How about now? Everything okay now? Just walk up. To be honest, we can't even see you. And I'm sorry if the other light was bothering you, if it hurt your eyes or whatever it did. Can you come up and put your hand in front of the light? Then it was gone.
Wow. That is an amazing device right there.
The handycam picks it up well?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got the whole thing.
Good. All right. Well, tough to beat that.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's keep moving.
This is the oubliette. And this essentially has not been touched by anybody other than archaeologists.
Big drop down here, Bradford.
I knew that when Paul and I decided to check out the oubliette, it was going to pose quite a bit of a challenge, being the fact that it was a tiny tunnel and it was filled with dirt and some of it was coming apart in our hands.
Wow. Wow, this is way more than I was expecting.
Apparently, this oubliette, it's actually derived from a French word to mean to forget. And apparently they would throw people down here.
Okay, you know what? Let's just get ourselves established. Let's just sit down for a bit. Just get a feel for the natural sounds in this place.
Okay, I just heard something. Did you hear that?
It wasn't your stomach.
It was just like,
ooh. Like a woman's voice.
Paul and I decided to basically sit down a bit and just get a feel for the location. And as we both noticed a voice of a woman. It sounded like a faint whining voice.
I heard that. I totally heard that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did hear that.
I thought it was your stomach.
No. I ate right today.
Initially, I thought it was perhaps Scott's stomach. But when he also said he heard it and it wasn't, then it was very interesting.
It just goes up and up and up.
There's more?
I can't get to it, but there's more up here.
It did sound something like a moan. So when it comes down to analysis, that's something I want to really look for.
All right, everyone, we have investigated this place from top to bottom and back again. Let's get to Command Central and get the lights on.
I believe the investigation here at the Galleries of Justice went really well. I mean, what could be a better time to have 8 investigators all primed and ready to go? I think that everyone really worked hard, and now we start going through the evidence and see what turns up.
It's going to be a good analysis. We have a lot of information to go through, a huge location spread over 7 floors here in Nottingham, England, and hopefully we've got something to bring through to our client.
There did seem to be a lot of activity being suggested throughout the site,
mm-hmm.
And so let's see if we've captured any of that with our devices.
I think I have a potential EVP.
Rob and Scott.
We're investigating the modern cells.
Mm-hmm.
There's actually a potential voice on here, which I don't think you guys heard at the time. Take a listen to this.
Still hearing this?
I can hear it, yes.
We both felt that it was interacting. I mean, like I said, we were there and it was dropping
mm-hmm.
around us. It was responding with the mill.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we were both dying to hear if anything came out on audio, because that
yes.
would be interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it helps solidify what the activity you were actually getting. So
good. Well, let's force ahead on and see if we can capture anything more. Guys, I've got something from the courtroom. Now, let me have a look here. Oh,
wow.
Hello to the Galleries of Justice again. You've got to tell me what happened.
Quite a bit happened, and the good thing is we're not coming here just telling you stories about what happened. We've got the evidence to back it up.
That's fantastic.
One of the first things we want to talk to you about is the personal experiences, the things that we weren't quite able to document, but were still experienced.
You know, over the course of the investigation, Martin, all the teams were experiencing the sounds of footsteps from all over the location itself. There was a voice that was heard in one of the courtrooms, and down in the lower sections of the building itself, the sounds of voices and movement was heard. And that continued right up to Rob's investigation as well, where he was experiencing a lot of different things, temperature changes and things.
What we experienced in the modern cells, Scott and I don't even know if you could describe it as cold spots. I mean, this was like jumping into a frozen lake. The temperature difference between this 3-foot area
And then if you walked right next to it, forward, back. I mean, we checked the windows. We looked for the drafts. We looked for anywhere, you know, where could an air current be coming from? Nothing. And it would come and go. Well, what we'd like to do for you now is actually play the audio from that time when we were noticing the cold spots in the modern cell.
Still here with us?
Now we'll just highlight that a little closer for you.
Still here with us?
Yeah, it definitely sounds like yes or some sort of return to your question.
Yeah, exactly. That wasn't the only response that was captured. We want to play you another response that we picked up on. This is, again, myself and Scott in the modern cells.
Yeah, very, very clearly.
We'll loop that section for you so you can see what you think it says.
It's definitely getting out. And it's a very, very strong whisper. And also, there's no accent there. It's definitely an English accent as well.
Like I said, this was surprising for us because, you know, we're experiencing the cold spots and we're saying, could this be paranormal or is it just something strange? And then to find out that we have this kind of response was really good.
Mm.
Paul and Ashley were in the dark cell, and during their EVP session, this is what they picked up.
Definitely seems to be saying you're right. I think all the way through with these EVPs that you've got, they've all got an English accent.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, the next thing we want to share with you, this one took place in the dark cells. I investigated there with Carl. We were hearing noises from other places. So we asked, can you make a noise right near us, within this room? And I want to play for you the response we got.
But we asked for something to make a sound. Yo.
Can you hear that sound in the middle section there?
What is that? Is that rattling or tapping?
It distinctly, for us, sounded like tapping. And here's why it was even more interesting while we were investigating. From within that cell, we were standing just outside. We were about 4 feet away from the cell, and we heard distinctly small tapping.
And the tapping was coming from inside of the cell?
Absolutely.
Wow.
With the technology that we use here at GHI, we have been really pushing for this full spectrum technology where we see a broader span of the EMF band than what the human eye is capable of. So I took Susan to the courtroom. As she sat on the judge's chair, something unusual occurred. What you see here is Susan sitting on the chair, and I wanted to focus the camera on her position and see if there was going to be any change that we could document and bring forward. As we can see, everything stays pretty much the same, everything's fine, and then this appears in front of the chair.
Okay.
And the next shot is gone.
So would you say that's a shadow? Is that?
It's not so much a shadow, more of a mist,
right? Okay.
Type of affair.
So keep in mind as well, she was denoting that there were some physical changes going on. So it's nice to have the evidence here to back that up, to say yes, there was apparently something there with you that was causing these changes.
Now, there certainly is something strange going on with the courthouse as a whole, because several of our investigators were also having issues trying to track whatever was in the courtroom down. Do you hear that?
Is that coming?
What the hell is that? What is that?
What the hell? Something's playing with us.
And it's gone.
Yeah.
It's just so fast.
Yeah.
Is this place haunted? Well, we have how many voices that from the beyond apparently talking to us? We have pictures, we have video, we have multiple devices with this interaction. Yes, the Galleries of Justice does certainly appear to be haunted.
Excellent. No, that's great. And thank you very much for coming in, because seeing this evidence from you guys is absolutely brilliant. So please thank your team as well. Thank you.
Absolutely, Mark. Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. Will you head out?
Yeah, okay. I think the team coming here and showing me the evidence tonight has just been astounding, because it backs up the stories that we hear so often at the Galleries of Justice. So to hear the evidence, to see the unusual photographs, and to have an international team come here with that amount of equipment has just been great.
It was nice to have Carl and Susan come out. And Scott, I really like the guy. Plus, anytime we can go to a new country and hear Scott do EVP sessions with his Queens accent, just warms my heart. Excuse me, Mr. Ghost, do we have a problem?